Hello, Mir here with the next ELEX guide. Today I'm going to show you what are the best ranged weapons in my opinion. And stick around to the end of the video if you wanna know where you can pick these weapons up. Sharing the fifth place, we have a rocket launcher, which is probably one of the prettiest weapons in the game, especially when you have it on your back. And also a heavy slug thrower, which is also a pretty nice looking weapon. You can see. The reason why they are on 5th place, because they are heavy weapons actually, I decided to include the heavy weapons also in the ranged weapons, but because they are kinda similar, but you will see. The idea is, they are heavy weapons, they reduce your movement, you can only like dodge like this, and you cannot use the jetpack. There is one exception, the grenade thrower is also a heavy weapon, and it doesn't like restrict your movement. And let's look at the stats and then we'll look at a demonstration for this weapon. So the stats for a rocket launcher, this is the highest damage in the game, is 125, and it requires 70 strength and 70 dexterity. It has few modes, but you're probably going to end up using just fragmentation rockets, because these rockets, you need to be an outlaw and they're quite expensive to craft, so I don't know how useful they are. That is why this weapon also is on the end of the list basically. Heavy slug thrower does 118 damage and requires 68 strength and 68 dexterity, and also he has 3 fire modes, but as I said, like for this one also you have to be an auto to craft radioactive and shrapnel projectiles, so you're probably going to end up just buying projectiles from outlaw trader, weapons trader, and yeah, you end up using just that because this is pretty expensive to craft. And now for a demonstration. Okay, so let's shoot the troll with the rocket launcher. A pro tip is take a tiny bit of higher ground, because if you shoot directly at the troll, there's a really good chance that you'll miss. You're better off like shooting at his feet. That way you won't be missing as much. There we go. By the way guys, this is on normal. I didn't want to do it on ultra because it's going to take a lot of time. And probably most of you guys are playing on normal, so yeah. So shoot at his feet and you end up knocking him. There we go. Hey, let's look at heavy slug thrower now. Okay, I like this weapon a bit more than rocket launcher, because you can shoot directly at the troll, not at his feet. This one tends to like have a bigger collision. You can like shoot at his feet, is always kind of a bit better, but you might end up like hitting him like this, where with rocket launcher there's a really good chance that you won't, basically. And tends to fire a bit faster, I think. Hey, that's a heavy slug thrower for you guys. On fourth place, we have a legendary grenade launcher called the Widowmaker. It's a pretty nice weapon, and it's pretty unique that it has a burst firing mode. And being a grenade launcher, you can use your jetpack and just roll around and everything. This is a heavy weapon, but it's kind of a smaller heavy weapon. That is probably why you can do everything like with other ranged weapons. This is the only heavy weapon that allows this. And here are the stats. So the Widowmaker does 114 damage, it's pretty high, and requires 60 dexterity and 82 strength. This is one of those weapons that requires more strength, less dexterity, and it's really good as a secondary weapon for a melee character, and then later on you can increase your dexterity and have more damage. But also he has one socket, so you can throw even more damage into it, or you can throw in again for healing, which is really awesome, especially that this weapon fires really fast because of the burst mode, which we will see just about now for a demonstration. Okay, let's look at Widowmaker. against the troll. I really like this weapon because you can fly and roll. The only thing kind of holding it back is because it's a heavy weapon and you wouldn't get like a buff if you're a cleric. And also crafting these other grenades is pretty expensive. That's why I have it on a third place. And let's do this. As you can see, it's the kill potential is pretty high, but it wastes a lot of ammo. Let's do it against this mob. Yeah, I really, really love using this weapon. There's a really satisfying feeling because it has this burst firing mode. There should be like more enemies here somewhere. Yeah, and you can do this. You can fly. I just got excited with this weapon, but I won't like go on a hunt. Like I said, it's all these weapons are pretty good, and maybe you can have it higher on a. Maybe you can say this weapon is better than a Vorbow or the other weapon that I'm going to show you, but. If you like this weapon, definitely use it. It's pretty cool, especially if you're an outlaw, because then it works with a chem or clerics. It doesn't work, and as a berserker, you can use it. Why not? Taking a third place is probably one of the best weapons in the game, which is a Vorbow 3. I have it on a third place. I have a reasoning why I have it on a third place, but let's first look at the stats, then I will explain that. So. We have 120 damage, requires 78 dexterity, 56 strength, and has 3 firing modes, so just regular arrows, seeker shot or scatter shot. Scatter shot is pretty interesting, but you have to be a berserker, and berserkers are kinda not deranged factions, so yeah, it's cool if you're a berserker, but I don't know, just the regular shots are pretty good. Either way, if you are an outlaw, you can use the double damage chem, so you will do way more damage. And if you're a cleric, you can use range buff and again do more damage. You do not get the seeker shot and scatter shot, but you will output more damage at the range, because scatter shot is only good when you're really close to an enemy. And my reasoning why I have this Vorbow on third place, it is because this is really an end game weapon, and it doesn't have a useful utility like a knockback or something like that. That is why it's not on a first place or even a second place, because it there's a weapon that does more damage, has better damage output, and there's a weapon that I think is has way more utility. That is why it's on a third place, but it's still probably one of the best weapons to use at the end game. I would definitely get a Vorbow and the next two weapons and have them equipped in all the time, basically. Alright, so for demonstration, and then we'll look at the next weapon. Okay, let's do the demonstration with the Vorbow against Troll and that other mob. So, Vorbow is probably one of the favorite weapons of many people, as I've seen. It does really nice damage against the Troll. Like, the Widowmaker is probably going to kill it faster, but this thing, against on a normal difficulty, against some mobs is pretty, like, powerful, because you can one-shot them. Okay, let's do it against this one. Bam. Like, it's a really nice weapon. Taking up a second place, we have a Mortal Beam. This is a legendary rifle, it looks pretty nice, and also does really nice damage. You could put Vorbow instead of this weapon on a second place. I would use both weapons. This one is really good against smaller targets. And Vorbow tends to work better against trolls and bigger targets. Now let's look at the stats. So, does 106 damage, definitely lower than a Vorbow. The cool thing is that it has magazine size of 23, and cool thing is Mutant Killer plus 1, so we would get Mutant Killer stat. And it has 3 modes, Single Shot, Burst, which is my favorite, and Full Auto. Full Auto is kind of a bit hard to control. And requires 59 dexterity, which is pretty Okay, and 83 strength. This is pretty high. This is like a good weapon as a secondary for a melee character in the beginning. Later on, you can max out your dexterity and do more damage. Also, he has one socket, so you can throw in a damage gem or a healing gem. And let's have a demonstration with this weapon. Okay, let's look at the Mortal Beam. Now, I want to let you know about something. Like, this first mode, I think it does 106 damage, basically. But the second one, the Burst, it's not three times that 106 damage because you're firing three bullets. They tend to, like, do less damage. I didn't, like, fully test it out, but I'm pretty sure they do less damage. And this one also, like, it's not 106 damage, is think it's less on a full auto. I may be going to test that out, but I just wanted to let you know that that is how I think. And even the icon kinda maybe suggests it, but I'm not sure. Hey, I'm going to show you the first firing mode on this mob. So as you can see, the war bow one-shotted, this thing didn't. But if I was to use this firing mod, I would have one-clicked it, basically, because I'm firing a burst mode there. And let's do it against the troll. So I'm going to do the first shot. This is how much it does, definitely less than a war bow. Let's look at this. And let's look at full auto. Yeah, I do not really like the full auto. I would use it on a burst, maybe exclusively. Really depends if... just look at this. Hey, I think I've missed with one shot. Let's find... there's one more mob. But it should one shot him. One click, basically. Let's wait for it to, like, stop moving so I can... as you can see, we pretty much kind of one shot it. It's kind of really similar as a war bow. You would probably almost one-shot him. Either way, it really depends on what difficulty you're playing, what's your dexterity level, and do you have maxed out range weapons. So, kind of depends if you're going to one-shot it. Hey, let's look at the next weapon. And taking first place is the Redeemer, the legendary plasma rifle. Looks pretty cool, similar to Mortal Beam. Let's look at the stats and I will explain why I have it on first place. So, where it is, the Redeemer, that's 100 damage, pretty okay. What's kind of important about this weapon is the shot modes. Single shot, okay, not that important, but EMP and Plasma Ball are insanely powerful. Plasma Ball is going to knock back enemies and you can pretty much stun lock most of the enemies. EMP is going to sleep robots, which is also pretty awesome. And the requirement is 65 dexterity and 65 intelligence. And he has one socket, so you can even throw some more damage or healing onto it. What is unique about this weapon? This is the only kind of the only type of the range weapon that requires intelligence. You can get the other weapons, like the lower tier weapons that require intelligence and dexterity, and this is really awesome because you go to combat range weapons. I have it trained to max so you cannot see, but they also require dexterity and intelligence to train. So in theory, until you kind of max out like the range weapons here, you will do more damage with this weapon than with the other weapons, because you will get 30% more damage basically with this. And later on you can pick up Warbow and also the Mortal Beam and use them in conjunction with this weapon. When you're fighting lots of enemies, you can use this one to knock them back. And when you're fighting a single enemy or a big troll, you should use Warbow or Mortal Beam for that matter. And the other thing why intelligence is so important, if you go to survival, you will need intelligence and dexterity for animal trophies, which are really, really, really good. Because in this game you can craft those ELEX potions, and to craft them you need money. And the easiest way to get money is the animal trophies. You just kill mobs, collect animal stuff and sell them, and you are going to become OP really, really fast this way. So that is why I recommend as a first weapon the Redeemer. Actually, it's the second weapon, because the first weapon you would need something with a less stats requirements. So I'm going to show you the location for that one, but you should go for a plasma rifle PT3. There is a plasma rifle that does more damage, does 42 damage, but this one is more convenient to pick up. You can get this one at Alp Separatists Converter, where they are, and I'm going to show you the location. And now let's do a demonstration of this weapon, then I'm going to show you all the locations for these weapons. And let's look at a Redeemer. So I'm going to show you the Plasma Ball mode, which is probably the mode that you will be using all the time. So you wanna shoot at his feet, basically. Bam. You could actually shoot directly at him, but this kind of works better. Especially if there are like few mobs. Against the troll, you do not have to shoot at his feet, but yeah. Because it's kind of easy to hit. But sometimes you end up missing, so yeah. Yeah, that's definitely more shots, but you are stun locking the enemy, and it's really good against few enemies. Well, I will show you the single shot, basically. Yeah, that's kind of more damage, I think, than the plasma ball, because you're not doing the direct damage, you're doing the splash damage when you do, like, shoot at his feet, but yeah. And this is kind of... all the weapons that I've shown you are really good, so... like, I did put them in a list, but... they are all really good. It really depends on your situation, what you want to be using. So you guys, let me know what's your favorite weapon. And also, if you want to pick them up, I'm not now going to show you the locations of all of them. Alright guys, this is all for this video. Thanks for watching. Let me know in the comments below what's your favorite weapon. And if you enjoyed this video, it took like some time to make it, and it would be really nice if you can hit that like button. And if you enjoy my videos, make sure you subscribe to my channel, hit that bell notification icon, and hope to see you in the next one.